Fundamental Theory of Calculus, please help. Okay, let's have a look. Right here we have the integral going from 0 to 4 of 1 over t dt. And we're supposed to use the FTC, and technically the second part of it, to evaluate this definite integral. And let's do a quick review. When we have a definite integral going from a to b of some function f of x, what we are going to do first is we have to find an antiderivative. And usually we just write it as capital F of x. And if you want to make it clear, you will indicate that if you differentiate capital F of x, you get the little f of x back. So that's the first step. And then you will plug in numbers, and usually I draw something like this. A here, B here, and you plug in B first, you get f of B, and then subtract, plugging A. And then just work that out, and that will be the answer to that integral. So now, let's think about it. We have the integral, and we will have to first find an antiderivative for 1 over t. And notice, in this case here, we are going from 0 to 4. I know there's a bad number already, but let's just proceed and see what happens. First though, 1 over t, do not use the reverse power rule for that. Do not write it as t to the negative 1, and then try to add 1, because otherwise you get 0, and then divide it by 0, you can't divide. No good. So you have to think about the derivative of what function will give us 1 over t. Note that if we differentiate ln t, we get 1 over t. Okay? And here, we just need 1 over t. We don't need the absolute value because we don't have negative numbers. So step 1, you get ln t. And then we will have to kind of plug in numbers, huh? 0 and 4. So it looks like we have ln 4. And that is okay. That's the first part. But when we plug in 0, this is like, what's going on? What's ln of 0, right? Now, I have two things in mind. One, it's either the question was bad, because if you're just doing the Fundamental Theorem of Calculus Part 2, there is a condition of using this right here. In order for this to work out nicely, you have to make sure that f is continuous on the interval a to b. However, the problem is that when t is equal to 0, it's undefined, right? 1 over 0 is undefined. But that's at the end point. So you will just have to be super careful. Now, the second thing I'm suspecting is that you are actually doing not just a regular integral, but you are doing an improper integral. So you will have to make sense of ln of 0 by taking limits instead of just like putting this down as that undefined. So let's see how that works. So let me give you the graph for 1 over t first. And we just care about the first quadrant because we just want from 0 to 4. And remember, there's another portion here. And interpret this as the area under the curve. This is y equals 1 over t. We want this area here. Now the problem is, we cannot plug in 0 into here. It's undefined. So what do we do? Instead of plugging the exact number 0, we are going to go to the right a little bit. So I'm going to put this down right here. I'm going to call it a, because that's a lower number here. So have a look. Instead of integrating this from 0 to 4, I'm going to integrate that from a to 4, and then 1 over t dt. Now, this is doable, because a is not equal to 0. But how can I make sense of that, though? Well, we'll just have to make sure that a goes to 0 as close as possible. And since a is going toward 0 from the right-hand side, we will take the limit as a approaching 0 from the positive direction. So this is how you make sense of an improper integral by doing something like this. I'm not so sure if it's meant to be the improper integral question or it was just a typo, but suppose it is, let's continue. So here we have the limit as a approaching 0 plus. And now for the inside, just like earlier, we get ln t. But now we are going to be putting a here and then 4 here. Putting down the 4 first and then subtract putting down the a. We still have the limit as a approaching 0 plus on the outside, and we have ln 4, and that's totally okay. And then minus ln, put the a here. So it's actually a limit question now. This is just a constant, so it doesn't matter. But the problem with this right here is that we have to think about, what's ln a as a approaching 0 plus? So to make sense of this, we will have to look at the graph again. If you look at ln, this is y equals, let's say ln x. As x approaching 0 from the right direction, you see that the function goes straight down, right? So the limit as x approaching 0 from the right-hand side of ln x, this gives us negative infinity. Same thing for the a, of course. So what we get is, this right here is ln 4, and then the minus. But this portion is what we said, it's this. So it's a minus and then negative infinity, like that. Now, minus negative infinity is plus infinity, and ln 4 is just a finite number, plus infinity, the whole thing is infinity. So what does this mean? Well, if you interpret this integral as the area under the curve, then the infinity shows you that for this region, we have infinite area. And it could be the case because you see that the curve goes straight up to infinity. We end up with infinite area. So you can answer this as past infinity, or if you look at this right here, because the answer is not a finite number at the end, you can also say this integral diverges. Let me just spell that out right here. Hope this helps. If you have any more questions, feel free to leave a comment down below and let me know. That's it.